ABC News exclusive. For the first time ever, a journalist was allowed inside the secret factory in China where Apple iPhones and iPads are made. In recent weeks, a number of reports have raised serious questions about the workers there, the long hours, the pressures, the low pay, the life. ABC's Bill Weir made his way into the giant factory and tonight tells us what he saw.
Her name is Xiao Ying. She's a 27-year-old mother of two, and she makes a living slicing apples, trimming aluminum burrs from those iconic iPad logos. She has helped make hundreds of thousands of these coveted gadgets, but since it would take 3 months' salary to buy an iPad of her own, this is the first time she's ever seen the final product, and her eyes light up.
That's my daughter, yeah. She likes climbing trees.
Your daughter is cute, naughty, she says, which is poignant since her kids live 2 hours away and she can afford to see them just once a month. But this is typical for most of the 235,000 who work in this one Foxconn complex. Many leave distant villages where families live in rooms like this.
How do you stay warm?
To share a dorm room like this with seven strangers. Foxconn attracts a lot of business by having workers close to the assembly line. They spend 12 hours a day in the factory with 2 one-hour meal breaks to march single file to a massive canteen for meat and rice. And if they eat fast enough, they'll grab a nap back at their spot on the line. And if Foxconn ever needs more workers, there are always crowds of applicants like this, all hoping to earn a wage Americans haven't seen since the 1950s. While the average worker building electronics in the U.S. today makes over $23 an hour and works 41 hours a week, most of the people at Foxconn earn just over $2 an hour and strive for a 60-hour work week. In a world ever hungry for gadgets, these people are all too easy to exploit. And ever since 18 Foxconn workers jumped from these buildings, Apple has been accused of doing just that. The suicide nets are still in place, just in case. So after years of monitoring suppliers themselves, Apple joined the Fair Labor Association last month and asked them to examine working conditions at Foxconn and publish the findings. And they invited us along. For the record, our parent company Disney has strong ties with Apple. The CEO sits on the Apple board and the Steve Jobs Trust is the majority individual shareholder of Disney stock. But we promised to report whatever we found.
If you could improve one thing about your job, what would it be?
We're all here to work, so naturally we want better pay and benefits, she says.
What do you want the people who end up buying this to know about you?
I want them to know me, she says. I want them to know we put a lot of effort into this product, and when they use it, please use it with care.
She was very sweet. The results of that FLA audit should be out in a couple weeks, and of course, we'll have every detail.
So what do you think now when you look at your iPad?
You know what I hear? I hear that automated voice, the computer voice on the line that says, okay, 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 hundreds of thousands of times. I think about her and not ever having seen one of these things. And I realize that this thing honestly changed my life. I'm a big fan of this product, but it's changing their lives in a way too.
But Apple did increase salaries recently, right? Is it going to be pressure to do even more?
I think so. They just gave a raise on February 1st. But this is a conversation every producer, every manufacturer of every product at Walmart should be thinking about right now. Their lives, their trip up the value chain is rising.
That's right. It is always moving to see how hard they work, how far away from home they live. Thank you, Bill.